the Wright State volleyball team, we are a family. I think our culture is awesome here at Wright State. The players, athletic trainers, we all care about each other, and it's a really great environment that you want to be a part of.
This season kind of started very crazy, as everyone knows, with the pandemic. When we got the go-ahead to compete, it has been challenging, but it's one of those things that we're just happy with anything at all. So the masks aren't ideal, and the social distancing and the quarantining and the measures we have to take to be safe aren't great and always easy, but we're just happy to be able to compete.
Far side Alders. Alders ties it at 16. Megan Alders.
Over the break, we all did a lot more cardio work so that we would be better prepared to wear the mask the whole match.
A lot for me defensively. I like to call shots and tell people where to hit, so like it muffles what I say, so like the miscommunication is something that we had to overcome. I mean, it's been tough, but each day gets easier.
I think that there's been times that we rely on other people in our lives during this time when we're trying to not expose ourselves to anyone outside of our circle. We've really had to depend on each other for, you know, all of our ups and downs throughout the season, and it's brought us a lot closer.
The challenges that have came and not being able to see each other for such a long time and then coming together, it's really brought us closer. And I mean, we're like sisters. It's like a huge family to us, and I wouldn't want to be out on the court with anybody else but them.
The weirdest part for me is having the no fans, because at Wright State, our fan base is just so amazing. Like, our parents are always so supportive.
Good frontline play by the Raiders. They can take advantage of their size up front. This time they're going to go right back to Teddy Sowards.
And just when we get a big point, it's like just our celebration, and I kind of miss that atmosphere, but hopefully we can have that in the fall.
This time has like taught us so much about the Wright State community and our friends and our fans and other athletic teams that come to support us and administrators and
dug out by Roskopf.
So now that we have to compete without it, I think that when we are able to safely have fans again.
And the Wright State Raiders have evened it up.
We're just gonna appreciate it that much more. So I can't wait to see everybody back in the gym. I'm excited to have that support again.
Action when we come back. Raiders take set two, 25-23.
Highlink has always kind of been the standard academic library consortium for the country and really for the world. WSU was a founding member. It started out back in 1992, and it was to share resources among member libraries. And it's a way to kind of reduce costs and increase access to items for the students at these Ohio institutions. We serve now 500,000 students across the state, over 117 member libraries. So each day we get the requests from the central catalog.
We're looking over for a book that's going to Cuyahoga County Public Library.
You know, we go up to the shelves, we have someone pull the book. But if we have the book, we go down, we process it in the computer so the other school knows it's on its way. My department really works with the physical items. So we're bagging the books and the CDs up, and we're sending them out. And we send, you know, maybe 15,000 a year, and we get about 15,000 back for our patrons.
There are still people who want to get their hands on the actual materials. They whatever still want to be able to have the books in their hand and be able whatever to read or page through to find the information that they still want.
You know, the average cost of an academic textbook is about $100. Just the cost for the courier to do a round trip to send the book to us and to have it go back, you know, it's a couple bucks, like $3. But OhioLINK is still trying to stay on the cutting edge of consortium. And, you know, their new focus now is on affordable learning and trying to just reduce costs for students in the state.
It's breathtaking. It's amazing.
Well, today I'm standing in the Charles and Renate Frydman Educational Resources Center. This is a brand new featured collection within the university libraries. We moved it here from Allen Hall back in August. The collection is just about finished.
These are called Ellison die cuts.
Equipment is out and students can come and borrow materials or use the facilities to study. It's really open for anyone to use. We want to get these resources out into the K-12 schools. The items from the Dayton Holocaust Resource Center, we really want to get those out into our schools to help our students understand about the Holocaust and what it meant and what it means now.
It's unbelievable. You have to know that we started maybe with 20 videos and, you know, a handful of books, and now something that anyone could use and find what they're looking for, hopefully. And we have great people here who will help them do that.
So this collection of several thousand materials and many recordings, a lot of movies, et cetera, that can all be borrowed by schools or, you know, people here at Wright State.
I just wanted kids to know that they have a chance to be a person who makes a difference in the world.
When they walk through the doors, I hope they find a place that they feel comfortable in.
They're used in classes for story times.
I hope they find that libraries offer more than just academic books, that we have a lot of equipment and supplies to help teachers and set up, you know, classrooms. But I'm so happy with it. I think it's just a wonderful use of this space. I think the room was waiting for it, and I think it's just the perfect spot.
Congratulations, Officer Thomas, for being the 2020 Officer of the Year for Wright State Police Department.
It was a shock. I mean, I wasn't expecting it. Very surprised and very honored.
Every year, we do an Officer of the Year award. Our officers and dispatchers here, they have to report every single day. And so I wanted to acknowledge and award our Officer of the Year.
Wright State Police, Dispatcher White.
Along with our dispatchers with the Distinguished Service for their outstanding service to the campus community.
You just rolled with the punches as best as we could. I mean, that's basically what this year has been about.
18 dispatch.
It was a lot of pressure, but it was an honor working here.
Officer Thomas has really stepped up this year. He has served in our field training program to help train staff. He is an officer in charge to help our supervision team. And also, he helped out the dispatch team by actually volunteering to go up there and learn how they do things up there and to assist to kind of alleviate any type of work hours. I really appreciate you. I want to give you Distinguished Service Award for Wright State.
You talk to us, but you don't see us. You see the officers and not necessarily us. And so it's nice to, you know, be acknowledged for that.
There you go, Whitney.
Thank you, sir.
No problem.
The second award I gave out was the Distinguished Service Award. I gave that to both Communication Center Operator White.
One, two, three.
And also Communication Center Operator Thompson. That Distinguished Service Award is for outstanding service during difficult times.
One of the things that I love to do in my job is training. I've trained pretty much all of the dispatchers here over the past 10 to 15 years. And that's the part that really gets me excited.
It means a lot to me to have Earl and Whitney and of course Billy, because they are incredible for the police department. Their commitment to Wright State is second to none. They want to serve our students, serve our staff, serve our faculty. And
I'll be 3-9.
My success would be anything without them being on the team.
All right, everybody, welcome. We are in functional training today. I like to say that this is where we have fun. This is where we relieve stress.
Drive that left leg up.
And there's a ton of research that supports that physical fitness supports academic well-being.
Give me a big breath. And as we exhale, we're gonna bring our hands down.
And helping you know, be a better version of yourself.
And then down, do a push-up. Nice job, you guys.
Campus Rec got approved to have in-person group fitness classes, so we're really excited to get those going. We have a really awesome schedule coming, a mix of cycling classes, functional training, circuits, strength training. We will have a mixture of both virtual classes for people who maybe are not on campus or maybe just aren't comfortable coming back yet. So we'll still have the same virtual schedule, yoga, different Zumba classes and circuits on that schedule also.
After a long year of being closed, our climbing wall is about to reopen. It's a really exciting time in the student union when our climbing wall is open. It brings a lot of life to the building. It's a place for students to try something new and test out their abilities and conquer fears of heights. And so we have lots of excited students who are able to come back and be on our wall again.
we see the importance that Campus Rec has on our community as a whole at Wright State. So
bring it down to a squat.
We believe we're doing this in the safest way possible according to research and following guidelines. So yeah, we have the rock wall opening. We have some intramurals happening right now, like distance dodgeball. So there's a lot of fun opportunities, and especially with this warmer weather, hopefully coming in the next few months, we can get a lot more outdoor stuff going too. Nice job. Shake it out a little bit. All right.
Welcome to the NCAA Women's Selection Special.
So we knew that no matter who we played, we needed to be prepared, and this team has done a great job of locking in and being ready to do that. It does seem like it takes forever, even when you know that your name is going to be called. But to be honest, we would have waited all night, so it's okay.
4-13 matchup. Little SEC flavor here. We got Arkansas taking on Wright State. Wright State making their third NCAA tournament appearance.
They could have quit. They had every reason to not keep going, to not keep pushing, to make excuses because we had to shut down or quarantine. Did everything that they could to keep their grades up. This is the highest GPA we've had in the 11 years that I've been here. And I think that it's just a testament to their perseverance and how tough they are. It's one of the reasons they're one of the top rebounding teams in the country. It just takes grit and hard work, and that's what they decided to lock in and do this year.
The most thing I like is we compete. I think that's my favorite thing about us. When we give each other our best, that's when we get better.
It's something that you can't take for granted. You know, a lot of people coach and play this game, and they don't get an opportunity to play in the NCAA tournament. I have been fortunate as a player and now as a coach to do both, and I'll tell you, it never gets old. And even when you know that it's going to pop up, that doesn't get old either. Seeing your name right there on that screen and just being appreciative for the opportunity to play this game, especially at a time like this.
This team's for real.
We're just really thankful.
Fourth seed, the Arkansas Razorbacks, out of the SEC, take on the Horizon League champions, the Wright State Raiders, from Dayton, Ohio.
So it's been such a hard season, right? We couldn't go to the Nutter Center and cheer on our teams. But Trina and her team have made it to the NCAA. It's in Texas. So we're trying to make it as much fun for everybody as we can to come here. So we have a watch event here on campus for students who don't want to leave campus. Socially distance in the Apollo room. Some good snacks for them to share. We also have a watch party at Milano's.
This is huge. This is putting Wright State on the map. I mean, right now, they're basically teaching an SEC team how to rebound, so it's really amazing to see.
This is a big game, you know. We want them to do well in the tournament and everything, so we just have to show them all our support.
I'm a part of the pep band at Wright State, so we go and play all the basketball games at home. Obviously, didn't get to this year, but I've been to the tournament. I went to the tournament a couple years ago when they made it, so it's just awesome to see them back there.
Another three. It's good this time from Angel Baker.
I'm so excited for Coach. She has worked so hard, and this is, it's stunning.
Wright State has done it. Number 13 knocks off number 4. The Raiders are moving on.
Something to get excited about in these times, you know. It's just something to rally around those women who play really well, playing with their heart out there. It's just something for the school to get behind. It's super excited.
They're all very good, communications well on and off court, so I'm not surprised that they won.
NCAA tournament win.
And the way that they've come together as a team and fought through a lot of adversity, this is a great women's basketball team and a testament to how our athletics treats our students and how Coach treats our players. We'll be here again, watching again, and I can't wait.
Always feels good to dress up and take pictures.
We didn't get to have our regular media day in the fall because of COVID protocols, so finally we get to wear our all-black outfit, dress up, take pictures with our teammates and like our coaches, and then do like a team picture. And this year, something new, we get to wear our championship gear and plus the trophy too, so we finally get to like do like a casual dress up picture with that too.
Just having pictures today was important. For like it was a nice way to just bring it all in, soaking up in the moment what we did for the team. And it's always good to link up with the girls for sure.
Another three is good this time from Angel Baker.
But I had fun practicing in the Alamo Dome, just still being with my teammates and like the exposure and everything.
Wright State has done it. Number 13 knocks off number 4. The Raiders are moving on.
Just making a little bit of history is important, but it's also fun just being with a group of people that really decided to just buy in even when it was tough. So I think that makes it a little more special. But always being able to
first NCAA tournament win.
Leave it a little bit better than you find it is always a great feeling. So
all the stuff we went through and just being able to pull it off with a championship win, a ring, and knocking off the number 4 team was just, it just made everything more special and just so much fun. And I think this group specifically is just special. And we made history here at Wright State, so of course we're special.
A lot of uncertainties, but the best thing about this team was we stayed together through it all, through the ups, the downs, even the ugly moments. I feel like that was the best thing, that we stayed together.
Hopefully now, like next year when we can finally have fans or something like that, like we'll get more people there to finally realize like the women's team is special.
Down cross town, living like a rock star, spend a lot of money on my brand new guitar.
So Raiderthon is normally a 15-hour dance marathon celebration. So Miracle Makers is the student organization that puts on Raiderthon. And they raise money for Dayton Children's and raise awareness for children's health all throughout the year. And Raiderthon is our celebration. Last 7 years, we've raised a little over $300,000 for Dayton Children's Hospital. Raiderthon's a bit different this year. So the students got together and they started thinking about what could they do.
School was great, all right?
And we're gonna have a drive-in movie. So we were really excited to be able to find a way, right? We wanted to be able to see each other and celebrate the end of the year and celebrate Raiderthon. That drive-in movie gives us that opportunity to meet outside. We can have up to 200 people at our event, so, you know, please come.
I love that we're doing something to help local kids.
You know where I go when we're dancing.
We wanted to make sure our morale dancers were there. So they're going to be there in their color gear trying to cheer everyone on. We're going to have videotape of them and they're going to teach their dance.
I got the eye of the tiger, the fighter.
Everyone will learn how to do Roar, which is one of our signature songs we've had since the very beginning.
That Raiderthon, a lot of the proceeds this year are going to go towards the mental health wing at Dayton Children's. So this year it means even more than it has in previous years.
Hey, feeling good, like I should.
It's just going to be really a fun time to get together, to be together, and to celebrate and raise some money for Dayton Children's.
Got that sunshine on my Sunday bed.